Some of the measures that we can take are publicly available, like as in the SARS situation. So for example, we are looking at, for the tourism related industries, some of the measures that we can take and we have taken previously include, for example, property tax rebate, reduction in the foreign workers levy for unskilled workers, the easing of the working capital through a temporary bridging loan. So all these will help to reduce the risk of the business being insolvent and leading to retrenchments. On the other hand, with the slower pace of the activities in some of those selected sectors, we can also take the opportunity to step up our training for the people involved in those sectors. For the another example would be for the transport sector, we could reduce the business cost to the rebates on the taxes, fees and dues for the transport sector. And this we will all study in detail. In fact, we have started work with the respective trade associations and chambers. Now, why we have not given a specific number yet is because of the following reasons. Number one, it depends on the severity of the situation. Now, every crisis is a bit different. So while SARS, haze, all this gives us a certain baseline, it is not a template. It is a baseline upon which we can build on. The second thing I think we have to be aware is, the second unknown that we have to be aware is the length of this crisis. For SARS, at the depth of the crisis, it was a very intense 3 months. Then after that, we were able to clear it. For this particular situation, we are still at the early stage of the development, and it will be premature for us to prejudge how long this will take. But I'm confident that working together with the TACs and the labour movement, we have the means to understand the depth of the impact and then to put in the necessary measures.